Sairam students, welcome to another lecture of English grammar. Today we are going to continue with part 2 of grammar topic subject verb agreement. In the previous lecture we learned what is subject verb agreement and also few rules. In this session we are going to continue the remaining part of the rules. So let's get started. Rule number 10. When a plural noun comes between a singular subject and its verb, the verb agrees with the singular subject. So what it means here is, when a plural noun, like in this example, each of the apples is juicy. Here the plural noun apples comes between a singular subject each and its verb is. So here the verb is agrees with the singular subject each. Alright, so when there is a plural noun that comes between a singular subject and its verb, the verb will always agree with the singular subject. Rule number 11. The verb should be put in singular if words are joined to a singular subject by using with. Now let me explain this with the help of this example. The Prime Minister with his cabinet colleagues is supposed to be present. Now here in this example the rule states that the verb should be put in singular if words are joined to a singular subject by using with. The singular subject here is the Prime Minister. Okay, it is joined with the remaining part of the sentence using with. So in such case we use a singular verb is. In this case we use is. Okay, so that the verb should be put in singular if words are joined to a singular subject by using with, as in this case. When the subject is joined using as well as, the verb must agree with the first subject irrespective of whether it is singular or plural. So in this example, my friends as well as my colleagues are going abroad. So when the subject is joined using as well as, verb must agree with the first subject. Okay, here we have friends as the first subject. So friends is a plural subject here. So our verb will also be plural. So if you see the example, my friends as well as my colleagues. Okay, so the first subject is friends. So we have the plural verb are. Okay, so this are plural verb agrees with the first subject. My friends as well as my colleagues are going abroad. And this is applicable when the subject is joined using as well as. Rule number 13. Two nouns qualified by each or every, even though connected by and, require a singular verb. Now what does this mean? I'll explain this rule with the help of the example here. Two nouns. Let us take this example. Every boy and every girl was given vaccination. So, two nouns qualified by each or every. Now, in this example, if you notice that the two nouns boy and girl are connected to each other by the conjunction and. Okay, and here why are we using a singular verb? Because when we say every boy and every girl, it means in a class where there are many children, we are referring to each and every boy. So we are talking about a singular subject, every boy. And every girl, that means in a class where there are many girls, we are talking about every girl. Okay, so we are talking about every child, every girl in the class. Okay, so that means we are talking about a singular subject here. Hence, we are using a singular verb, that is was. Every boy and every girl was given vaccination. Moving to the next rule. Rule number 14. None is singular but takes a plural or singular verb according to the sense involved in the sentence. So none, it is singular, but we take plural or singular verb depending upon the sentence. Now let us see two different types of sentence. One which speaks about plural verb, whereas the other example tells us about a singular verb. Okay, let us take the first example here. None were given a chance to speak. Now what it means here? None were given. That means there were many people and none were given a chance. Okay, so here we are talking about plural subject. That there were many people and none were given a chance to speak. Hence we use the plural verb were. Whereas in the next example, I asked for a maid, but none was there. So here, I asked for a maid. Okay, we are talking about a maid. So not a single maid was ready to come. Alright, so we use singular verb was. I hope students, you understood this rule as well. When the plural noun is a proper name for some single object or some collective unit, it must be followed by a singular verb. So what this rule says, when the plural noun is a proper name for some single object or say some collective unit of people or a collective unit of countries, so in that case we should use a singular verb. Like in this example, the United Nations. United Nations is it's a unit, it's a association of countries. Okay, so United Nations is not an effective body for world peace. So here we are using a plural noun that has a proper name. Okay, and it's a collective unit. So in that case, it is followed by a singular verb is in this example. Moving ahead. The next rule is rule number 16. Nouns like glasses, pants, trousers, shoes, people, police, scissors always take a plural verb. Also, descriptive nouns like the rich, the blind, the guilty are always plural. So, let me tell you students, in this rule, it says that nouns like glasses, pants, trousers, shoes, so all these nouns, here we always take a plural verb. Okay, also descriptive nouns like the rich, the blind, the guilty, they are always plural. So we use a plural verb for them, for these words. Example, your shoes are glossy. But when used with a pair of shoes, okay, when we use it with a pair of, when this particular words are put together, then we use a singular verb. Like we have seen two examples taking this word shoes. Okay, the earlier example says that your shoes are glossy. Okay, so here we are not using a pair of shoes. Here it's just the word shoes. Hence we are using a plural verb. But in the next example, we are using a pair of branded shoes. So in that case, when we are using a pair of, then we use a singular verb. A pair of branded shoes is quite expensive these days. Okay, moving ahead, rule number 17. Uncountable nouns like advice, news, media, progress are singular and take singular verb. So these uncountable nouns mentioned over here, advice, news, media, progress, they are uncountable, we cannot count them, and they are singular, so we take singular verb. like in this example, one must not offer advice unless asked for. Okay, so in case of uncountable noun, we use a singular verb here. Rule number 18 says, nouns like physics, measles, aerobics are plural in form. Because if we can see, you know, these words end with S. But they are treated as singular. Aerobics is a good exercise. Okay. So here, though they appear to be plural in form, but we consider them to be singular and we use a singular verb. Like in this case, is. Rule number 19. A collective noun takes a singular verb when the collection is thought of as one whole. It takes a plural verb when the stress is on the individuals. Let me explain this with the help of an example. A collective noun takes a singular verb. Now here, the example. The cartel of oil supplying countries. Cartel refers to an association. So, the cartel of oil supplying countries has submitted its report. What it means here is, cartel which consists of a number of countries. Okay, but this is one cartel. Okay, one cartel that consists of oil supplying countries. So, this cartel has submitted its report. So, here this we are talking about this cartel as one singular subject. Okay, hence we are using a singular verb has. Whereas in the other example, in this rule, it says it takes a plural verb when the stress is on the individuals. So, with reference to this point, we have the example here. The cartel of oil supplying countries are divided over the issue. So, the stress here is on individual oil supplying countries. Okay. So, the stress here is on each and the stress is on oil supplying countries. Hence, we are using a plural verb are. Okay. So, the cartel of oil supplying countries. So, when we are stressing on individual subject, then when we are stressing on this individual thing, then we use a plural subject. It takes a plural verb when the stress is on the individuals. So, I hope students, this point is clear with you. 20. Singular verb is used when a plural noun denotes some specific quantity or amount. So, singular verb is used when it is used when a plural noun in the sentence will denote some quantity or some amount. Okay, quantity in the sense 150, 1/3, 2/3. Okay, so this kind of specific quantity is mentioned in a sentence, then singular verb is used even though there is a plural noun. Now in this example, 150 rupees is too much for this bag. Okay, here some amount is denoted. Hence, we use a singular verb. 2/3 of the city is in ruins. So, here 2/3 is the number mentioned. So, here hence we use a singular verb. Now, there are certain exceptions that we need to remember. Remember that a few nouns are always plural, even though they don't end in S. So, there are certain nouns which are always plural, even though they don't end with S. Like in case people, police, children. Okay, they don't end with S, but they are plural. Okay, so in that case, they will always take a plural verb. Now, let us see this example. People. Now, people is a plural. Okay, it's a plural subject here, but it doesn't end with S. So, it will take plural verb. Let us look at this example. People have such strange ideas. People have such strange ideas. We have people as the subject, which is a plural noun. Okay. Whereas, we are using a plural verb. Have. The police were baffled. Police again is a plural noun and we are using a plural verb were. Also, quite a few common plurals don't end in s. There are a few more that don't end in s. Let us look at these examples as well. The children are in bed. Children, the children is a common, it's a plural and we are using a plural verb are. My feet hurt. Her teeth are rather uneven. My hair are brown in color. So all these examples are they are good examples showing that though we have a plural subject, plural noun that does not end with s, but still we use a plural verb. I hope students you are clear with the rules. Okay, so we are done with all the rules for subject verb agreement and now I am sure you will be able to solve this exercise along with me. So let's get started with this exercise. Choose the correct form of the verbs given in the brackets in the following sentences. So you have to choose the correct verb that is given in the bracket. We have given two verbs in the bracket and you have to choose the right one that will fit in this sentence. The jury dash divided in their opinions. The jury dash divided in their opinions. So what will be the answer? The jury was divided in their opinions. Second question, there dash many exceptions to this rule. There are many exceptions to this rule. Neither Ramesh nor his friend dash hurt was hurt. Slow and steady wins the race. The poet and the singer are dead. So here we come to an end of this session. I hope students you understood this topic and do not forget to click on the link so that you can complete your home assignment. Thank you so much.